Kumbakonam. This temple city has set an example for Tier 2 cities of India by effectively managing both its legacy plastic waste and new plastic waste, produced mostly by its thriving food industry. The city converts non-recyclable portions of plastic waste into refuse-derived fuel for cement factories and recycles the rest. With an estimated floating population of 25,000 people a day, Kumbakonam had some serious decisions to make to spearhead this project and implement it. These have been detailed out in this episode of The Cleanest Cities of India. Kumbakonam is a special grade municipality situated in the Thanjavur district of Tamil Nadu. The temple town generates 72 tons of waste every day. Out of this, more than a third is non-biodegradable, majorly plastic.
Many years of the waste were not separated as biodegradable and non-biodegradable. So they were all accumulated in one place known as curriculum, that is in the outskirts of Kumbakonam.
Unsegregated waste at Karikulam rose 20 feet above the ground, spreading over 7.5 acres of the 10.5 acres of the dump site area. The biggest problem remained the ever-increasing quantity of plastic waste, mostly of the non-recyclable variety, but also a sizable quantity of recyclable plastic. Since it was mixed with other wastes, there were no takers for it.
Sir, actually, plastic, we are generating a plastic about 22 metric ton per day in Kumbakonam municipality. Namma eppo vandu solid waste management bylaw la plastic banded plastic nam bylaw vandu create pannamo appo vandu nama wholesalers producers andha mari irukravangala vandu totally ban pannom avangala vandu plastic production e illama plastic cups or plastic plates plastic tumblers andha mari irukravangala totally andha mari irukravangalukku license vandu nama kudukkuradhu kedaiyadhu andha thozhil pandradhukku.
Segregation at source had to be mandated. It was also recognized as the most important step to create a plastic waste-free city. This was not an easy task for the Kumbakonam municipality. They needed support.
So when we as a team members, when we saw how much of difficulty the municipality had to do all this work and the manual work with the sanitary workers, it was also one of the main initiatives for us to start this work. And that's why we wanted to tell the people to minimize the use of plastics, and if at all they use it, we want them to separate it as biodegradable and non-biodegradable.
Volunteers would also draw kolams at garbage vulnerable points to stop people from dumping waste. In time, the reluctance among citizens to segregate waste faded away.
Initially, around 20% of the people didn't respond well, but 80% of the people encouraged us. Every day we'll have the waste being collected from each and every house. Each house they'll be collected, and afternoon every day the sanitary workers will separate it then and there daily. So that's why the town was able to do it up.
The municipality has integrated authorized waste pickers into the management system, thus addressing the shortfall in the number of sanitary workers.
மொத்தம் எனக்கு நாலு வார்டு கொடுத்துருக்காங்க. இந்த நாலு வார்டுகள 4,035 வீடு மொத்தம் இருக்குது. 50 ஒர்க்கருங்க மொத்தம் இருக்காங்க. ரெண்டு ஒர்க்கருக்கு 264 வீடுகள் கொடுத்துருக்கு.
நாங்கள் 18 வருஷமாக வேலை பார்க்குறோம் நகராட்சியில். 6 மணிலேருந்து 10:30 வரைக்கும் நாங்கள் டைம் வேலை பார்க்குறோம். நகராட்சியில் பிரித்து குப்பை வாங்கணும்னு மீட்டிங்லாம் போட்டிருக்காங்க. நாங்கள் அதை மக்கும் குப்பை மக்காத குப்பைலாம் பிரித்து வாங்கணும்.
The authorized waste pickers asked the residents to segregate their waste before collection. Kumbakonam residents diligently cooperated with the request, which made the waste collector's job easier. All plastic waste is segregated into two parts, recyclable and non-recyclable. The recyclable plastic is converted into saleable material or products, and the non-recyclable plastic is sent to the cement factory. Kumbakonam Municipality roped in Zigma Global Environ Solutions Private Limited to reclaim the dump site. A resource recovery facility was set up on the land recovered at the dump site. The biggest triumph of Kumbakonam's waste management system has been its processing of non-recyclable plastic from the city as well as the dump site. Use of plastic as a refuse-derived fuel also reduces the need for pet coke in cement factories. Kumbakonam now sends its waste to Dalmia and Ultratech cement factories. The municipality only bears the transportation charges.
To support the environment and to conserve the fossil fuel, we are using alternate fuel in Dalmia cements like Biomind RDF, paper mill plastics, MLP plastics. We are having a tie-up with 40 municipalities and we are getting the material in an unshredded form. The material will be directly unloading in pre-processing unit. In pre-processing unit, we will store the material to bring uniform CV and moisture. We will mix all the material and we will do shredding. The input size of the material, it will be around 300 to 500 mm. After shredding, it will be less than 80 mm. Then the shredded material will be collected in tippers and it will send to the co-processing unit. Then the shredded material is fed into the hopper. And again, we are having a 315 meters long belt conveyor for transportation. Then the material is fed into the pre-calciner.
All the bulk waste generators, such as big shops, malls, and hotels, were in a hurry to find the next alternative for plastic. So, they suggested the use of plastic containers and reusable plastic for emergencies. However, Kumbakonam municipality was insistent about getting rid of all forms of plastic and only using cloth bags and steel containers instead. Chennai Silks was one of the first companies to adopt the new regulations. They banned the use of its silk-like plastic covers, which they had been using up until 2017.
அப்போ முனிசிபாலிட்டிலேருந்து எங்களுக்கு வந்துட்டு நிறைய கைட் பண்ணாங்க. நம்ம வந்து இங்கே கும்பகோணத்தை வந்து பசுமையாக நம்ம மாற்றுறோம், இங்கே வந்து நாங்கள் இந்த நான் ஓவன்ஸ் இதெல்லாம் வந்து முற்றிலுமாக தவிர்த்துருங்க அப்படின்னு சொன்னாங்க. அது உடனே நாங்கள் ஏன்னா இப்போ முனிசிபாலிட்டி கவர்மெண்ட்டோட ஆர்டரை உடனே நம்ம ஒபே பண்ணி எங்களுடைய பிரான்ச்சஸ் எல்லாத்துலேயும் பார்த்தீங்கன்னா நம்ம அந்த நான் ஓவன் பேக்ஸ் எதுவுமே கிடையாது, அதே மாதிரி பிளாஸ்டிக் கவர்ஸ் எதுவுமே நாங்கள் யூஸ் பண்ணுறது இல்லை. அப்போவே பார்த்தீங்கன்னா காடா கிளாத்து நம்ம துணிப்பையில் வந்து துணிப்பை தயாரித்து எல்லாத்துக்குமே நாங்கள் கொடுக்க ஆரம்பித்தோம். அதே மாதிரி பேப்பர்ஸ் பேக்கிங்க்கெலாம் யூஸ் பண்ணுறது பார்த்திங்கன்னா நாங்கள் ப்ரௌன் பேப்பர்ஸ் பேப்பர் கவர் தான் இப்போ நம்ம எல்லாத்துக்கும் கொடுத்துட்ருக்கோம்.
Kumbakonam's case proves that processing single-use plastic is a technically feasible solution for a city with proper segregation of waste. However, proximity of co-processing facilities is an essential factor for end use of refuse-derived fuel, as the cost of transportation is a factor. Across the country, 11 projects similar to the Kumbakonam plastic waste processing model have been completed till now. Kumbakonam has also found a viable market for reuse of recyclable plastic. The municipality is promoting a form of reusable plastic
அதில் என்ன நம்மளுடைய எக்ஸ்பெக்டேஷனாக அந்த 20% நம்ம வந்து ஒரு 70-80% பிளாஸ்டிக்ஸ் வந்ததை இப்போ வந்து ஒரு 20-30% வச்சுருக்கோம்னு வச்சுக்கோங்க. அந்த 30%மே நமக்கு வந்து ஒரு பர்மனன்ட் சொல்யூஷன் வேணும்னா இட் கேன் பி ப்ரொடியூஸ்ட் ஆஸ் ஏதோ ஒரு ஆயில் பால்ஸாவோ ஏதாவது ஒரு ஷெட்டர் வச்சு மேக்கிங் ரோட்ஸு அந்த மாதிரி போடுறதாவோ அந்த மாதிரி தான் பிளான் இருக்குது. ஆல்ரெடி நம்ம பண்ணியிருக்கோம்.
While the financial returns are not sufficient at present, the municipality considers it as a profitable deal in terms of the environmental advantages of recycling or processing plastic. Many cities and towns in India are already following the footsteps of Kumbakonam. This is the testament to its replicability.